Hi-res audio has now become a standard feature when looking for a new audio device, whether that's headphones, earphones, or portable players. It has also become a rating for high-quality music files. That little gold logo has become very important. But what does it mean? To understand what high-res audio is, it's worth having a basic understanding of digital audio and how it's recorded. The majority of music we listen to these days, at some point during the recording and mastering process, has been made into digital audio. Whereas once upon a time, audio was recorded onto tape and then cut straight onto vinyl, a completely analog process. Nowadays, music is mainly recorded onto computer drives using software like Pro Tools, Ableton, or Logic. Tapes are still sometimes used to record onto, but they tend to be transferred onto the drive as well. The recorded audio is converted into digital audio and then stored onto the drive to be edited in the software. Historically, digital audio has been available in a number of different audio file types. MP3 and AAC are not high-res formats. They are early developed file types that compress audio data in order to achieve small file sizes, convenient for storing on devices with minimal storage while compromising on sound quality. Nowadays, this compression is used on streaming services such as Spotify and Apple Music, so it's worth knowing that however convenient they are, sound quality will be compromised. There are four main file types which are capable of storing high-res audio. They are WAV, AIFF, FLAC, and ALAC, or ALAC. The quality of these file types can range from 16-bit CD quality audio up to the highest high-res audio quality. WAV and AIFF are raw, uncompressed formats which are not commonly used for general listening due to the very large file sizes. FLAC and ALAC are the most common used formats for high-res audio. They are both lossless compression formats, which means the file sizes are much smaller and they can store metadata, which is all the information about that piece of music. Now, the complicated part. Before high-res audio became mainstream, music was typically recorded with a bit depth of 24 bits and a sample rate of 44.1 kHz or 48 kHz. The bit depth determines the number of bits of information in each sample and the signal-to-noise ratio, while the sample rate determines the number of samples of audio taken per second. If you want to know more about bit depth and sample rates, then I would suggest you do some research online, as there are a lot of articles on this. Alternatively, you can ask us down below and we'll do our best to answer. The digital audio on a CD is always 16 bits and 44.1 kHz. This is a standard process for CD and was calculated by very smart people to get the best from this format. Before high-res audio was a format we could easily listen to, CDs gave us the best digital audio quality, with Super Audio CDs providing the high-res audio of its time and an early glimpse of DSD audio. We'll save that for another video. Now, thanks to portable audio players having high-quality DAC chips and also very large expandable storage, high-res audio is something we can all experience wherever we want. Unlike CD quality, high-res audio has a minimum bit depth of 24 bits and a sample rate of up to 192 kHz. To achieve this, the audio has been recorded at a much higher sample rate than was done before. This requires a lot more storage as the data is much larger. The upside to this is that the higher bit rate provides more decibels of dynamic range, meaning the 24-bit recording has a dynamic range of 144 decibels, compared to the 96 decibels provided by the 16-bit CD recording. The result is more headroom for peaks at the recording stage, avoiding the risk of clipping. It also gives a greater separation between the recorded audio and the noise floor. Using a larger sample rate will increase the amount of samples taken of the audio per second, and this is where it gets tricky. The higher the sample rate, the higher frequencies a system can record. So a sample rate of 44.1 kHz reproduces frequencies of up to roughly 20 kHz, and increasing the sample rate will increase the frequencies that can be produced. Technically, this seems like a no-brainer, as more information can be captured during the recording process, making sure to grab all the detail possible. The argument to this is that we can only hear frequencies up to 20 kHz, and that's pushing it. So, why would we need more? Well, that seems to be a subject where no definite answer has been determined. Feel free to give your opinions to this below. Right, here we are. Is high-res audio worth all the fuss? If you have a very good set of headphones or earphones, and you use them with a very nice portable player, or plug them into a high-end home system, then I'd say that you will notice the difference between CD and high-res audio. On the other hand, if you listen to music on your phone using the earphones supplied with it, or you listen to your music wirelessly, then CD quality will probably be as good as you need. Saying that, most people still listen to Spotify and seem very happy with it, so what do I know? And don't even get me started on vinyl, or we'll be here all week. Thanks for watching, and happy listening.